Jai Hind and good afternoon again to the new session of our Vartalap. And today, for a change, we have a veteran with us. And like the last few session, today not any one from the martyrs' families, but we have Lieutenant Colonel Rajib Ghosh with us. Lieutenant Colonel Ghosh is a second generation officer of 4th Jat Regiment. Following his father's footsteps, he joined the battalion in June 1996. He has served in various operational areas ranging from high altitude to the counter-insurgency operations in Northeast. He has actively participated in Operation Vijay in Kaksar, where he was awarded Army CDRS Commendation Card. He also has been awarded a Sena Medal and COAS Commendation Card for gallantry for counter-insurgency operations in Northeast. Presently, he is working in a corporate in Mumbai after taking premature retirement from the Army. He is survived by a wife and a lovely daughter. And today, we have Lieutenant Colonel Rajib Ghosh with us, and we will request our Rajib Da to share his experience as an army personnel, as a soldier, and obviously his experience in the Kaksar sector during the Kargil operation.
Before that, I would request sir to, as we have told in the introduction, that he is a second generation into the armed forces. I would request Dada to also share about, tell us about.
Thank you so much. Thank you, Madhurja. Thank you, Anita. First of all, I would like to thank all of you to give me an opportunity to come on this platform. And before I speak and tell about myself, I would just like to give a small introduction that we are all are going through a life and of the entire so it is that to hold ourselves, remain strong, and show our mettle now, because we all are locked down, a lot of financial crisis, a lot of people are facing domestic crisis, because you're locked inside a house with your wife, with your children, nowhere to go, so people are losing patience. So this is the time we have to actually step to our mettle and prove it, helping your wife or patient or remaining patient with the child. Everybody is running out of patience, so it's become a big cost. So with that, thank you. My name is Rajiv, and was born to a Fauji. My mother was 4th Jat. He is Dilip Kumar Ghosh from 4th Jat. Is no more the Ghosh. He was born to them in the year 1972. It's a long time now. Since then, my parents took the life. So I was kind of motivated, to join the army and to join the Jat Regiment, because Jat Regiment is a very old and very brave regiment of the army. And though I'm a Bengali, but I have a lot of affinity for Jat, because it's a very different kind of people, very highly motivated and very humorous kind of people. These days you must be seeing a lot of Jat coming up. Earlier they were not there. In Patal Lok, Jaydi Pilawat is there. So Jat have very different kind of character. In the worst of situations also, their humor and wit never goes. They're always humorous, always wit. And very strong people. Very strong. Typically, they're, I think, one of the strongest in the country. They are very physically fit. So that motivated me to join the army. I joined Jat Regiment. So, landing up in my own father's bed. So, that time, I unit Faragat. The Faragat, which is near the Chinese border, close to Chinese border. In the area of Uttarakhand, it is there. It's a mountainous area. So, that was 21 years old. And the old people of the unit of the case. They were the ones who had seen me as a small child. So a lot of people used to call me by name only. They never used to call me as a small child. So it was a part of the game. In fact, first party, his name was Jagat. And I didn't put my buddy. So those days I smoke, you know. Now I smoke in a long time. So when we come in the morning, you give me a cup of tea. So we used to get early in the morning before 4:30 because we have to practice for Hardak competition, sort of. So he used to wake me up, get a cup of tea and light a cigarette, take two puffs, then give it to me. So that kind of cigarette. Toragarh is to be a very old place, winter here. So that's how I used to get. So this is the love and affection which I used to get from them. Because for them, you know, I was somebody different. And in my unit, I think I was the second generation officer who had joined. It is very senior. So then we put in Pitharagar for about 2 years. That time, the CO, the commanding officer, was Colonel Peter Newman. My PC was Colonel Jyotirmay Pichal. Both of Bengalis, being in a government, both CO to IC were Bengalis. Again, I had these two gentlemen as my uncles when my father was there. And they were there as my superior. So, but the treatment which I got was not like a, you know, young boy. They gave me a very harsh treatment so that I could officer. And I was treated like any other officer, and in fact, maybe more than that. So that, you know, I don't get to see a very cushy life. And they gave me a lot of physically active jobs. I was put in Ghatak competitions. There's a competition. Ghatak is a commando competition, you know. And it is the most prestigious competition for any infantry to win it. And just all the infantry talents, they fought. And it's in which the commando of every unit part. And it's a very tough competition. It has got things like endurance march of 34 kilometers, a lot of things are there. So I was there at the competition, as well as there is a competition, which is a rifle shooting competition, which is again a very prestigious competition because Ghatak and Kabir, these are two very prestigious competitions for any infantry battalion. So I was there in Pitharagar. We were there for almost 2 years. So that is how my career began. Then once I was 2 years of service, our unit moved to Kargil. 1-to-1 infantry unit in Kargil. So we were in the area of Kargil. These days, you know, everybody was with names. Earlier, nobody used to be there.
Sir, can you use a earphone?
Hello?
Can you use a earphone?
You can't hear me?
A little, this will be a little better. It a little louder needed, yeah.
Yeah. Just hold on, I'll put a... Oh, yes. Just now, either you can put a charger or an earphone.
Yeah, it's okay. It's okay now.
Yes, yes, absolutely. Perfect.
So those days, you know, in 1998, our unit moved to Kargil. So nowadays, you know, because of social media and lot of opening up of people, information is there. Everybody knows where is Kargil, where is Uri. But when we were getting inducted to Kargil, nobody knew where is Kargil. In civil streets, nobody knew. In the army, those who had served over there, they knew. Am I audible?
Yes, yes, absolutely. Perfect.
Yeah. So, we went to Kargil. So it was in the year 1998. So Kargil is a high altitude area which all of you know, and it has become very famous after Operation Vijay. So when we got inducted that time, once you move from Srinagar towards Kargil, so you have to come from Srinagar to Sonamarg, climb across Rojila Pass, then go via Dras to Kargil. Via Dras you have to go to Kargil. So when you start climbing Rojila Pass, there's a place called Sonamarg, which all of you must be aware of. So Sonamarg is a place where we have high altitude warfare school. So before getting inducted to Kargil, I had the good fortune, I got a chance to do a mountain warfare course over there in Hawes, Sonamarg. Mountain warfare is a two and a half months course, which is a very tough course. It is almost like commando course, tougher than commando course. And it is one course which the officer and the jawans, they do it together. So every unit sends, you know, one officer, four or five jawans, and you form a small team and you do that course. It's a very prestigious and a very important course. So I did that course, and doing that course with Jat boys and, you know, matching up to their standards, it's something next to impossible. But still, I could successfully complete that course, and that course is a very nice course for any young officer getting inducted to high altitude. It teaches you a lot. So after that, we got inducted to Kaksar. We relieved the previous battalion, and then we got deployed in that area. So that area is one place which doesn't have much of vegetation. It is above the tree line, so there is hardly any vegetation. And in Kaksar, we were deployed in opposite the Pakistani posts from where they used to fire on National Highway 1 Alpha. There are two posts over there. One is called Bunker Ridge. One is called Twin Bump. They fire onto the National Highway 1 Alpha. So the all the supplies, administrative supplies, which goes to Ladakh and across Kargil, has to pass through that road. So what the Pakistanis used to do is they used to fire at night so that our convoys cannot move. And those days, that road via Manali, that was not there. So the only lines of supply or lines of communication was through this road only. So as a Kaksar battalion, our main responsibility was keep this road open. So to keep this road open, our main responsibility was to keep the Pakistanis quiet and make the convoys pass. But the Pakis, you know, what they used to do is at daytime they used to fire, at nighttime they used to fire. But at daytime they used to fire, so the convoys used to pass at nighttime. And nighttime Pakis used to fire, they used to fix their guns on that road and keep firing because at night they could not see. But we used to make our convoys pass, and there were days when it was around almost a 15-kilometer stretch, and the road was that time very narrow, not very broad, and just next to that there's a river. So, and the current of the river is so strong that if some vehicle falls, it will get washed away as if it's a, you know, alpin, not a vehicle. So our boys used to wear white kurtis and walk on the road and guide the vehicles, because vehicles were not allowed to switch on the headlights. So this used to be a regular story, and every night we used to do this. And Pakis used to fire, we used to make our convoys cross, we used to do retaliatory fire, and this was the story going on. So this happened in 1998. So 1998 winters, the snowfall was very late. It was very late. The snowfall generally used to start somewhere in September end. But that year, I don't know what happened. The snowfall was very late. So we had a couple of posts which were winter vacated. In that area of Kargil, Dras, Leh, Ladakh, the terrain is such inhospitable that certain places are there where you cannot sustain during winters. The snowfall is too high. So there were a lot of posts which were winter vacated. Even we had posts which were winter vacated. Even the Pakistanis had posts which were winter vacated. It was a sort of a mutual understanding that they will also vacate, we will also vacate. Because it was inhospitable for them also and for us also. So over there, when you have posts, you know, you have winter stocking for the posts. Depending on which post is at what severity, you have advanced winter stocking. Somewhere you have 90 days winter stocking, somewhere which is cut off for 90 days, somewhere you have 120 days winter stocking, somewhere you have 180 days winter stocking. So in my unit area, maximum posts were more than 180 days winter stocking, and two-thirds were more than 210 days winter stocking. So when you do winter stocking, you do stocking for a particular number of troops. You are aware ki yahan itna aadmi rehta hai. So you stock for them. Like say if you have a post where 20 people will stay, so you will do winter stocking for 20 people for 210 days. So similarly, we did winter stocking, and those posts which were not occupied during winters, we did not do winter stocking. So a couple of posts were there in my unit area, though everybody knows the names of the posts and all, but still I would not like to tell all the names to remain, to keep the confidentiality. So there was some number of posts which were supposed to have winter stocking for 210 days, and some posts were there which were not supposed to have winter stocking. So one of the posts which everybody knows is Bajrang. Bajrang was a post which was not supposed to have winter stocking. So I was a company commander of a post under which this Bajrang also came. So I was on a post which was winter vacated post. So we had certain amount of strength on Bajrang. So we used to, since Bajrang was not vacated because snowfall was late, so we used to give our rations to Bajrang post. So, since the post did not get cut off, so our rations we were sharing with Bajrang post. So, the from where we were giving rations, unka ration kam ho raha tha. So, they had 210 days stocking. We were sharing our rations with Bajrang post. So, our rations were going down. And there was no way we could get rations up because there is no, too much of reserves are not catered for. Little bit of reserves are catered for. Then its snowfall started somewhere in late December and January 1999. And then heavy snowfall started. Then we had to vacate that Bajrang post in somewhere in March. Exact date is 1st March 1999. That was the day we vacated winter Bajrang post. So I was the one who vacated that post. I was there only. So we vacated this Bajrang post, and things were fine. We used to go take our patrol and all at times over there. Then the snowfall was too much that we stopped going towards that direction, because then winter sorties used to take place. They used to see from helicopters and all. And we had observation posts at other places, but Bajrang got cut off, and then there is no means to actually see Bajrang. कि वहां क्या हो रहा है. देन इन एंड ऑफ अप्रैल फर्स्ट वीक ऑफ मे पीपल स्टार्टेड डिटेक्टिंग इंट्रूजन्स इन वेरियस प्लेसेस लाइक द्रास. 16 ग्रेनेडर्स वाज देयर इन द्रास. सो दे रिपोर्टेड इंट्रूजन्स एंड बटालिक 3 पंजाब वाज देयर इन बटालिक. दे स्टार्टेड रिपोर्टिंग इंट्रूजन्स कि पाकिस्तानी आ गए विंटर वेकेटेड पोस्ट पे. So, we have an exam called Part B exam. You know, as young officers, you have to give this exam. So, I was on that winter vacated post for a long time. So, I came down in the month of April. I don't remember the exact date. It was mid of April. We had Part B exams. And Part B exams, it was scheduled. Our center was in Leh. So, April 1999, I got down from my post. And I went to give Part B exam, and then after that I was supposed to go on leave. My parents stay in Kolkata, so I was coming to Kolkata after giving Part B exams. So I was relieved by a very dynamic young officer. His name was Saurabh Kalia, who is very famous. All of you almost know. So Saurabh, so yeah, he's my junior. We are from the same unit. So, so Saurabh relieved me in that post. So Saurabh came. He relieved me as a company commander in that post. He was that time 2-3 months of service. He got commissioned in December 1998. And he relieved me. So and I went to give Part B exam and then went on leave to Kolkata. So in April, this intrusions and all started, and then in the first week of May, this unfortunate incident of Saurabh happened, which all of you know. And Saurabh and Amit Bharadwaj. So this unfortunate incident happened, and then the entire battalion came in action, and then we took certain steps, and we fought back the enemy. But initially, we got some casualties, Saurabh and his patrol, and then Amit and his patrol. About Amit, I would like to tell a small story. You know, when I was in Pithoragarh, I got commissioned in June 1996. So when you are the junior most in the battalion, you are the one who is had the maximum, all the physical activities, all the orders. You don't have any officer whom you give, who can give orders. You only keep taking orders. So normally in every unit, you know, within 6 to 6 months or 1 year, somebody gets commissioned. So you have a junior. So in my unit, what happened is I got commissioned in June 96. In December 95, there's a gentleman called Vikram Shikawat. He got commissioned in Forjat. So he was 6 months senior to me. Then after Shikawat, sir, three months after him, there's one SS officer who came. His name was Ripan Tripathi. He came to the unit. So I had two immediate juniors. One was 6 months senior, one was 3 months senior. And since I was a parental claim officer, so I came to the unit. So I had two immediate seniors with whom I didn't have much of service difference. So after posting me to the battalion, the Indian Army forgot that there is a unit called Forjat and they also require another officer. So I did not have a junior under me for almost 1 year, 3-4 months. So I remember that it was 1997. I was 1 year, 2-3 months of service. And like a bechara junior, I was the only one who did not have any youngster under him. What happens is, you know, I will tell you, in when you have parties at night, na, the official parties. So after the parties, the junior most officer is the one who leaves last. He closes the mess. He ensures everything is closed. At times you go to the quarter guard, you keep the silver back. Then you come back to the room. And you reach the room by 2-2:30 in the morning, and 4 o'clock, 5 o'clock, you have to again go back for PT. So I used to think, yaar, kya zindagi, koi junior hi nahi aa raha. Even no junior is coming. I was disgusted. Like, you know, you don't have a child for a long time, so you keep asking God ki, yaar, Bhagwan mujhe bachcha de de. So that is what my situation was, ki I don't have a junior. Yaar, kya karu main, kab aayega junior? So I had gone on leave. I had gone on leave to Kolkata. So those days we didn't have mobile and SMS and WhatsApp and all. We used to have STD phones. That too, you know, full rate during day, half rate during after 9 o'clock, and all that different rates. So I called up the unit. So somebody told me, "Yar, tera junior aa raha hai, commission ho raha hai, OTS hai. His name is Amit Bhardwaj." I said, "Wow, finally there is someone. Finally there is someone, you know." So then came Amit Bharadwaj. He got commissioned in September 97. He came to the unit. And I had made a lot of plans. I will do junior ko aisa karunga, waisa karunga. But Amit Bharadwaj was such a simple soul. Such a nice and a simple soul. Ki badmash se badmash aadmi bhi na usko pareshan karne se katrata. Ki yaar, itna achha, simple, sharif ladka hai, isko kya pareshan karna. So, and I was notorious since childhood, you know, I used to keep, I was a very badmash kind of a child since childhood. So, I wanted to play a lot of pranks and all, but he was such a good chap that I never had that heart to, you know, play pranks with him or trouble him. So then, very good, we shared a lot of good memories and all. then the unit, when the unit went to Kargil, he was also there, but he had gone for Vyos course. He had gone for Vyos course. So I remember when I was doing mountain warfare. So one of the exercises in mountain warfare is Haste Aansu, which is a very, you must have, the name is very typical kind of name. The name of the exercise is Haste Aansu, and it is actually exercise where you laugh tears, because as soldiers you don't cry. So you laugh tears. So that exercise culminates after a long route march, about 80 kilometers route march through mountain terrain, 4-5 days of exercise, and culminates at Dras. So our exercise also culminated at Dras. So Dras is a place where I met Amit almost after 6-7 months, because he was coming back to the unit after doing his Vyos. So we both met over there, and we shared a room. Gappe vappe mara. Agle din he went to the unit and I went back to Mountain Warfare Institute in Sonamarg. So that is the time we met, and then when I came back to the unit, we met then off and on, you know, main post pe rehta tha, wo niche, wo post pe, main niche, wo chutti, main idhar. So we hardly used to meet on regular basis, but we used to keep talking. So in March 1999, I'll remove this because I have to put the charger. My
sure.
Go down.
You just come little forward, then we can hear.
Yeah. Can you hear me?
Yes.
Yeah. So in March 1999, I remember I came down to my post for. So just before 2 days back, Amit was going from Kargil to Leh. So there is a place called Jalebimud. So it's just cross road which down from the mountain to town, just then going to a place called. So over there, Amit vehicle met an accident. The vehicle toppled. So there were 13, 14 people, all of them. We went crashless. So he went crashless. He did nothing happened to him. So when we met, yes, we were sharing a room. So he told me, sir, dekho, there was kuch. He was very happy ki acha hua kuch nahi hua. Then I told him ki acha hai. Dilli ki tarah kaam hota hai. Tere ko kuch nahi hua. Tere ko kuch hoga bhi nahi. But unfortunately, you know, months back, he became immortal. You know, to be very frank, it is a dream of soldier. But again, only lucky people get that. Everybody is a dream of soldier. So we surviving a war is in a war is a bigger achievement. Nobody has ever become great. You become great by making the other chap die for his country. But yeah, but becoming immortal is something important. So he is one of those. But that so Kargil war was a very very dark chapter of our life, because we all were youngsters. I was 25-26 years old. That time I was not even married, and seen so much of sin, so much of death of people who were so close to me. So that leaves a these cars in your mind. Without being able to come out of it, and maybe I'll never be able to come out of it. I hope my voice is okay.
It's breaking actually.
Actually, kya ho raha hai? Main charger lagaunga. Any idea? Just. a very typical phone. Either I can put charger or I can.
Okay. We can't hear you. Oh, you mute me to the way. You have muted your voice is muted, Anush.
Oh.
Tell what you were telling. Anush?
Actually, through the earphone, the voice is coming very clear.
Very, very clear. Very good.
No,
I understand.
Just hold on. Give me 1 second. I'll do something.
Absolutely, sure.
Let us see. By the time it drains out of charge, till then I'll speak. Then I'll ask for your apology. Yeah, am I audible now?
Absolutely.
Sunai dera?
Yes.
So where was I? See, I will not go into the nitty-gritty of the Kargil war because I would not like to divulge everything nitty-gritty on the Kargil war ki kaun kahan gaya, kitne log gaye. But yes, as Forge Art unit, we lost a lot of brave men and the unit did not get its due, which we were supposed to get. We had a lot of officers, JSOs and men losing their lives. And as a unit, we had a very bad time because we were in a very inhospitable terrain and an inhospitable area. So a lot of units which were next to the road, you know, they got a lot of media coverage and all and became very famous. But our unit was deployed in such an area that उधर फौजियों का ही पहुंचना मुश्किल होता था तो मीडिया वाज नेक्स्ट टू इम्पॉसिबल सो वी डिड नॉट गेट मच ऑफ कवरेज एंड द यूनिट्स ऑफ होल्डिंग फॉर्मेशन दैट ब्रिगेड दे डिड नॉट गेट मच ऑफ मीडिया कवरेज बिकॉज ऑफ वेरियस रीजंस आई विल नॉट कमेंट मच ऑन दैट बट यस दैट वाज वन फेज ऑफ माय लाइफ व्हिच टॉट मी लॉट ऑफ लाइफ लेसंस एंड व्हिच विल सी मी थ्रू ऑल थ्रू आउट माय लाइफ लॉट ऑफ स्कार्स But then again, lot of good things, you know, lot of good things also came, like you become a better person, better human being, and then you get in touch with lot of people whom you never forget in your life, and you make lifelong friends. Like in our unit, there was a senior of mine who came from some other unit called Major Sunil Kumar. He's from Mechanized Infantry. You know, we became such good friends. He stayed in my unit for only 3-4 months. But during war, you become very good friends. You get bounded for life. Then all the officers of my unit that time, you know, Colonel Kukshal, Colonel Subaya, Major Jaswinder, Major Bhatt, Rajesh Tyagi sir, Sethi sir, all of them, we are not like unit officers. We are more like brothers. We are so close to each other. I have taken premature retirement, but still, you know, we are in touch. We keep talking to each other. We keep sharing our problems. Our families are very well bonded together. Then I'm in touch with Amit's family, Amit's parents, Amit's sister, his niece. I have not been in touch with Saurabh's parents. Because I've never got a chance after that to go to Himachal and meet them. But I could meet Amit's parents in Jaipur because my unit was posted there. And then his niece and all, they are in Bombay, so we keep meeting off and on. So these are lessons of life which you learn and you come to know new people. You see various face of people during tough times. In war, see, you know, war is a very challenging thing. कोई डर जाता है कोई नहीं डरता एंड आई विल नॉट से कि लोग डरते नहीं है डर हर एक के अंदर होता है एवरीबडी हैज गॉट दैट फियर ऑफ डेथ बट एट दैट स्पर ऑफ द मोमेंट ना यू हैव टू गेट ओवर दैट एवरीबडी हैज दैट फियर ऑफ डेथ बट दैट इज दैट स्पर ऑफ द मोमेंट विच मेक्स यू ओवरकम दैट फियर एंड टू ओवरकम दैट फियर योर ट्रेनिंग योर फैमिली योर यूनिट योर नेशन So many things make you overcome that fear. कि नहीं यार मैं मर जाऊंगा लेकिन मैं डरूंगा नहीं. Lot of people, there are some people who are not able to overcome that. डर जाते हैं कई बार, but ठीक है, they're not wrong. As soldiers, you know, it is part of life. So at times you have to motivate people. कि नहीं कोई बात नहीं. And but later on, after coming from Kargil, then you know, my unit got deployed in counter-insurgency operations. We were there in Udi also. But nothing could be as dangerous as the Kargil war, which I have seen from very close quarters. After that, you know, I've been deployed in counter-insurgency operations, line of control. But it was just like a cakewalk, you know. जो कारगिल से निकल के आ गया ना, 21 एक डेढ़ दो महीने की वो ऑपरेशन विजय लड़के, उसके लिए फिर बाकी कोई चीज़ चैलेंजिंग नहीं रह जाती फौज में भी और लाइफ में भी. फौज में तो चलो ठीक है, यू नो, यू गो थ्रू डेंजरस फेजेस ऑफ लाइफ, बट आफ्टर दैट नथिंग इज चैलेंजिंग फॉर हिम इन हिज एंटायर लाइफ, नथिंग. एंड वी बीन फ्रॉम दैट जनरेशन हु आर फॉर्चुनेट इनफ टू फाइट अ वॉर. एवरीबॉडी डजंट गेट अ चांस. So everybody doesn't get a chance. We got a chance to fight a war, and we fought it. Some of us survived. Some of us attained martyrdom. But we all got a chance to fight a war, and that is how life is. And now I'm in corporate. But those lessons of life which I've learned from Kargil and the army days is something which will see me throughout my life. I have realized in corporate also, in civil streets also, I've been here out for 3 years. There is no work which is not possible, which an army officer who has done his normal training and normal routine administrative unit jobs or operations cannot handle. Everything apart from technical things, administrative, security, man management, human resources, everything can be handled. And Sunita Didi is there listening to me. I can see her comments. You know, a word about her. She's we are very close to each other. She's Amit's elder sister. And on this, I am calling her Didi, but I've never called her Didi. I called her my name. And I keep pulling her leg also. And I've been a very nasty kind of a person. You know, I keep troubling her. Unko shayad jitna main sunata hoon, shayad koi nahi sunata hoga. I have got a complaint against her that she didn't invite me for her elder daughter's marriage. So I told her ki choti wali ki shaadi mein pakka bulana. And I am thankful to you guys, you know, to give me a chance to speak on this platform. And now I would request you, in case you want to ask me any questions or anything, I'll be happy to answer.
Sir, just let me ask you one thing, that in this present scenario, both for the pandemic and especially for Calcutta and Bengal, after this super cyclone, everyone is under a fear of death, fear of insecurity. They all are very much afraid of the situation. Can you give them a message to overcome the fear?
Anushaya, you, by asking me this question, now you make me feel like Sadhguru, you know. But still,
no,
I will try.
Actually, you know, sir, I'm just telling you one experience of mine. My mother was in hospital, and after her surgery, she was absolutely refusing to have anything, just because of that nausea due to the chloroform and all. And I was sitting beside her. It was probably 15th of May only. 15th or 16th, I was just telling her the stories of Captain Kalia. And Captain Kalia is absolutely about the age of my brother only, my elder brother, 76 born. So while listening to his story and everything, whatever I just read in books and newspapers, she just started to take the food, and my mother, she just realized that how much they have suffered. So you know the life to overcome the fear. Sadhguru probably doesn't know it. What do you know?
See, what my suggestion is ki And at this present situation with pandemic, with cyclone, with locust attack, with, you know, lot of people facing financial problems, you have to be very patient. Dimag ko thanda rakhna padega. You have to be very patient. You have to plan everything. You know, if now in today's date, even if you are very affluent, do not spend unnecessarily. Do not spend money unnecessarily. Usko phaltu mein paisa barbaad mat karo. Agar aap, if you are spending money, spend thinking that, you know, you have to survive for 6, 7, 8 months without money. Next month your salary is not going to come. Secondly, be patient. Abhi everybody is running out of patience. Ab at home if you are staying or even if you are going to office, agar aap impatient hoge, jhagadne lago, apne wife se jhagda karo, apne ghar walon se jhagda karo, to then you will run into problems. You have to give that feeling to everybody ki yaar we are safe. No, theek hai, koi baat. This phase will also pass. I will tell you, in Kargil, I will tell you one incident. We used to have rotis, you know. We used to have rotis. We have to have 2-3 bites, keep it back. On my post, once a patrol came that was led by a gentleman called Captain Rajesh Sethi. He is now a brigadier. So I offered him roti, sukhi roti. He said, ye lo. And he had that. Bola yaar bada tasty tune khana khila. And that time that every bite of that roti used to taste like, you know, the best food on this earth. And we used to have half roti and balance we used to fold it and keep it in our pockets. Ki agli baar kaam aa jaye. And all of us are from good affluent families. You know, all of us get a lot of good food to eat at home. But jab din aise the, तब ऐसे दिन थे कि आपको रखना पड़ेगा. सो नाउ इन टुडेज पेंडेमिक सिचुएशन वी हैव टू बी वेरी पेशेंट. दिमाग को ठंडा रखना पड़ेगा एंड दिस विल ओनली लीड अस थ्रू. एंड जो डर है ना, हर एक इंसान को डर लगता है. एवरीबडी हैज़ गॉट फियर इन माइंड, नो फियर ऑफ लूजिंग योर जॉब, फियर ऑफ सैलरी कट्स, फियर ऑफ चिल्ड्रन एजुकेशन. बट देर आर सर्टन थिंग्स विच आर बियॉन्ड योर कंट्रोल. Like my daughter is in class 10th now. She is doing her online classes and all. Pura din pressure hai, tuition ka, classes ka. But now if you put extra pressure on her, you have to get 100% marks, 100% marks, no. I know that, you know, under this pressure, it's very difficult for the child also to perform because the child is not being able to go out of the house. Jo bachon ki zindagi change ho gayi hai. They cannot go out and play. They are not being able to go to malls, McDonald's. Yeah, you know, their life is entirely changed. So now if I expect ki she will, you know, be get 100% or if I keep coaxing her ki itna percent lana, ab to aapko chance lena padega. You have to keep motivating the child. You have to keep motivating the child. And I will tell you, you know, a lot of people posting aaj ke hi khela on Facebook mein post kar raha, aaj biryani khaya, aaj ye khaya. I think we should remain away from that. मैं जो खा रहा हूँ यार, I don't have to tell. Neither I have to tell मैंने Facebook में क्या बिरयानी खाई या नहीं खाई, nor I have to post on Facebook कि मैं बर्तन माँज रहा हूँ, घर में बर्तन माँज रहा हूँ. माँज रहा हूँ तो माँज रहा हूँ यार, अपने घर में माँज रहा हूँ. You know, if the maid is not coming and if I am helping my wife in washing utensils, I don't have to go and tell the entire world. You have to be patient. You know, being men, we want to tell everybody on ki main to bartan maaj raha hu, main ye kar lo. It's okay, you are doing your job for the house. So remain patient, apne aap ko thande dimag se kaam karo. Remain patient, spend money wisely, spend national resources wisely, and this phase will pass. 1 year, 1 month, 2 month, 3 month, nobody knows, but this phase will pass. Anything else?
We don't feel like stopping actually.
Yeah, absolutely. Even I don't feel like stopping, but my mobile, unfortunately my mobile has only one port. Either I can put a speaker or I can put a charger. It doesn't take both. No. So next time I will buy a mobile with two different ports.
And then we will
again sing. Can we have you in a second session? second term of this session in during this Kargil series again.
People will get bored of my me because I am not that good looking also. And
actually, sir, we have to listen so many things. We wanted to
I don't
listen
think so.
About so many things, but we didn't want to also, you know, push you back to the painful memories. So, because हर किसी को लगता है वार 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 चलो लड़ते हैं चलो लड़ते हैं why we are not fighting a war कुछ भी इधर से उधर हो चलो वार वार शुरू करते हैं but those who have fought they know what it is
you know actually. I will tell you a small incident you know after before we close after the just when the Kargil war had just finished it was still not fully over so I was told to go and open up a post called which is ahead of Bajrang post so I went and opened up a new post called Anita post I named that post on my mother's name Anita so the day I came back to Bajrang after opening that post it was 17th of July and it was my birthday so that time again I told about Sethi sir he was there Captain Rajesh Sethi he was there with a party waiting for me at Bajrang so when I came back to Bajrang he hugged me and he said happy birthday so I hugged him and I must have cried for at least 15-20 minutes and that is the day I cried after the whole war because too much of bahut zyada ho gaya tha you know I couldn't take any more so you have to let it out kabhi aapko you know you have to let it out and as men also as soldiers also you know everybody needs to cry your emotions have to
Absolutely.
Come out so that was the day I cried almost after 2 months of undergoing all this and I cried for at least 15-20 minutes hugging him wo sar ka sab geela ho gaya hoga and then I could overcome after crying but these are the times you actually learn small things and in your unit you know I had good seniors like Colonel Kukshal was there he was my CO Colonel Subaya was there he was my 2IC we had an officer called Major Jaswinder Singh who retired as a brigadier then Major Asim Bhatt and I had lot of juniors also they we all used to give lot of strength to each other because aap jab weak padne lagte ho na to aapko kisi ka you need somebody and you need okay. people who can support you and see in war na kabhi na kabhi koi na koi thoda bahut you know emotional
damage
that time the other chap has to tell him ki nahi yaar theek hai kar lenge ek saath we can fight so this is the time this pandemic situation is one of those times of so wife is becoming weak you give her strength if you are becoming weak she will give you strength
absolutely
cannot be ki sab weak ho gaye ki wife bhi ro rahi hai ki bhai mar jayenge corona se tum bhi ro rahe ho no if she is becoming weak you give her strength yeah don't worry chill ho jayega and today I was reading in Mumbai Mirror that there are people who have had corona wo ghar pe baithe baithe treat ho gaye quarantine ho gaye ghar pe and they did not even go to the hospital they just reported to the hospital ki they are documented ki bhai this chap is suffering from corona and had home only they remained quarantined and they became negative corona negative they didn't even go to the hospital so that agony was not there because they may be having that mental strength and their family must have supported them kyunki quarantine mein wo aadmi kamre mein rahega niklega nahi aapko usko home delivery khana home delivery peena everything and you know to look after somebody in one room for 28 days giving thrice meal पानी चाय और उसका बर्तन निकल रहा है वो आपको धोना है आपको बहुत ध्यान से धोना है उस आदमी से ज्यादा उसकी फैमिली के लिए चैलेंजिंग है बट दे डिड इट
एग्जैक्टली
सो इट इज नथिंग इम्पॉसिबल वी विल गेट अवर ऑफ दिस
वी हैव अ मैसेज फॉर यू
व्हाट इज योर मैसेज फॉर द वंस हु वांट टू जॉइन द आर्मी Yes, my message is that Army is one of the best organizations in the country. You must join, but do not choose Army as a profession. Choose it as a way of life. ये नहीं कि भैया कुछ नौकरी एक profession जरूरी है पैसा कमाने. Army is not a पैसा कमाने का जरिया. It's a way of life, and it gets into you for the rest of your life. वो आपकी पूरी life बदल देगा. it becomes a part of your life. It becomes your way of life. So please, if you want to join the army, please join the army and join as a selfless person. Do not, today if you are joining, do not make your aim to become CDS. कि मैं तो CDS बनना चाहता हूँ. Join the army to become a soldier. कि मैं फौजी बनना चाहता हूँ. मैं soldier बनना चाहता हूँ. So join the army. If you want to become a CDS, then don't join the army. Then you will be working for your own self. Yes, if you keep doing well, one day you will definitely become the CDS also. But your aim should not only to be become CDS. Your aim should be become a soldier. Apne soldiering karte jao, apne kaam karte jao, apne courses karte jao, apne operations karte jao, apne discipline maintain rakho. One day you will definitely become CDS also. But if you don't become, don't feel bad. Because everybody doesn't become. It's a pyramidal structure in the army. So everybody doesn't become the chief. Become a good soldier. Anything else? Adrija, any other questions?
No. I just want to tell everyone that we need to have many more sessions with Lieutenant Colonel Rajiv Ghosh, because actually he's the one who has seen Captain Amit Bharadwaj, Captain Saurav Kalia, even Captain P.V. Vikram he has seen. So his experiences, but we will not bother him with all these things, but we will listen to sir's experiences.
Hello. Yes, sir. Yes. Yes. Anything you ask me, I couldn't hear.
Anushwa.
No, she just said that we don't want to bother you with the memories that will disturb you.
Yeah, it does disturb me. It does disturb me, but sure. if I speak and, you know, people can gather something out of it, or if my... See, I come from a unit which actually did not get much of recognition in Kargil war because of various reasons. So, if I speak and if people come to know about my unit, what my unit has done, what Forge Art has done in Kargil war, so I don't mind speaking out. And since I am in the civil now, I can speak. You know, a lot of people are there who are still serving. They cannot speak. But I can speak, though I don't want to name people ki isne galat kiya, usne galat kiya, no. Sabne apna apna kaam kiya. And but I would like to tell people about my unit. My unit, Forge Art, is a very old unit. It's one of the oldest infantry battalions of the Indian Army. It has seen almost all operations. It was re-raised in 1962. It was merged with the regimental center. Then it was re-raised in 1962. Since 1962, we have seen almost all the operations, and people have done wonders in this unit. People have done excelled in sports. People have excelled in career. People have excelled everywhere, and it's a very good unit. But we have not got our due. We should have got much more. Especially during Kargil war, but it's okay. People must be having their own reasons. But yes, we deserved much more, especially the martyrs, because they have fought a selfless battle. You know, people like Saurabh, people like Amit, they have sacrificed their lives for the nation. So, you know, they deserved much more than what they have got. But government policies and military policies, so I don't want to comment upon that. But yes, they deserve much more than what they have got. You would like to hear him again. Insurgency areas you have served and experiences and conditions you have faced in such places. There is no end to it. Aap ek soldier ko bulwate rahoge na, wo bolta rahega. Short stories, long stories. He will keep speaking, and I am a very dangerous combination. I am a mixture of being a Bengali and I'm being a Jat. So I can keep speaking, you know, because Bengalis and Jats both are good at speaking. Both are good at speaking, so I can keep speaking for hours together. Hello.
Sir, we can do one session with you in Bengali, I think.
Anushaya.
sir, we can have a session in Bengali with you.
But everybody will not understand that.
Yes, everybody will not understand that.
And my Bengali is not very purishkar also. And autota fluent na.
Wait, it's okay.
No, in fact, I will tell you a story. You know, there's a friend of mine whose mother had come from Kolkata. We were there in Firozpur that time. So I went and I spoke to her. I spoke to her mother. So then his mother told me ki you can speak to in Bangla. Aap Bangla mein bolo, mujhe Bangla samajh aata hai. मैं आंटी से बांग्ला में बात करने की कोशिश बांग्ला में मैं आंटी से काफी देर तक बातें करता ना तो आंटी ने बोला कि आप बांग्ला में बोलो तुम्हें बांग्ला बोलते पारो हमें बांग्ला बूझते पारी तो मैंने आंटी को बोला हमी आंटी है तो खुन दो तो हमें बांग्ला ही बोलती सो मतलब माय बांग्ला वॉज यू नो मोर ऑफ हिंदी माय बांग्ला वॉज मोर ऑफ हिंदी तो इट इज बेटर अभी हिंदी इंग्लिश बोली बांग्ला बोल ले
मैंने
हमारे बोल खुले जावे
ओके ओके नो प्रॉब्लम सर सो आई थिंक वी कैन हैव अ सेकंड सेशन विद इंसर्जेंसी एक्सपीरियंसेस एंड अबाउट द ऑपरेशन अबाउट अबाउट कैप्टन पीवी विक्रम आल्सो
Can we have that session after 3-4 days? You know, people will get...
Yes, absolutely.
If I come tomorrow also.
Absolutely.
Again in June.
Maybe after 2-3 days.
Absolutely. Even after 1 week, we can do. No problem.
Sure. And I will keep my mobile fully charged.
Yes.
Because this time, in between the conversation...
So thank you, everybody.
If the mobile goes out of charge, that will be very bad. So we should end it with a proper note from Rajiv sir.
Thank you, everybody.
Thank you so much,
thank
sir.
You
thank
all
you
viewers.
So much.
Thank you all, my friend,
yes.
For listening to me for 1 hour and for a patient hearing. And I hope I could, tell you some stories about my life, some stories about Kargil war. I didn't want to go into operational details
because
that becomes too much and that is something which I don't want to tell.
Yes.
But yes, it was nice talking to you and definitely I will next time come and share my experiences of counter-insurgency operations. I have had the opportunity to see counter-insurgency operations in Assam. In the northeast and in the line of control, we were deployed in Uri sector much before the Uri attack, about 2-3 years before the Uri attack. So in 2009-10, I was there. Then I was in Baramula also for some time. So I have got a lot of stories of that place. We'll be able to share. And in case you have any specific questions, you can let me know a day or two prior.
Sure.
So that I can guide you like Sadhguru.
Absolutely.
Like Sadhguru Anushya will ask me some question and I will give my experiences. But it was nice talking to you. Thank you, everyone. Thank you very much.
Thank you.
Thank you so much, sir, for coming in the live show.
Thank you.